In this video, I'm going to talk about how to study from books. Now, I don't want to take it for... The reason I'm making this video is that I don't think it's fair or wise to take it for granted that everybody is, you know, in college or, you know, an academically oriented person who wants to study occultism. That's part one. And part two is, even if you are, a lot of the study methods that they teach you in school don't really work very well for investigating occultism on your own, primarily being the fact that schools are oriented around a teacher-student relationship, lectures given, notes taken, tests administered later, laboratory experiences, group study, the whole sort of classroom environment, which just doesn't exist other than just in the form of occasional seminars and workshops that you might find at a bookstore or something. So I'm going to start with the very nuts and bolts of how to take good notes and how to choose good books and how to use books in occultism without being dependent upon them. So the first thing that you need to know about is how to keep a notebook, which is pretty straightforward. You simply get a notebook. I like graph paper myself to keep my own notes in, because drawing geometrical things, sigils and stuff like that, it's easier to keep it tidy on perpendicularly lined paper. And you know, this is my current notebook that I'm keeping, and there's not really much point in showing it to you because it won't make much sense. But generally what you want, the most important thing to do is to keep a notebook and date every piece of information you come across. You will kick yourself to the moon and back for want of a date that you wrote something down when you can't remember it. And one of the most idiotic things that I ever did in my life was spending a couple of years being very sloppy about, not only was I not taking notes, but what few notes I took, I didn't chronologue them. And that makes it difficult to check progress, and also makes a lot of relevant subjects difficult to cross-reference. So, anyway, keep dates. The dates of your notes in your notebook will line up with dates in your diary, which is another video that I'll make. But a notebook with dates of every piece of information you come across, even if the information is nothing more than a question in your own mind that you don't know the answer to. In fact, one of the first things that you could, a really good exercise, is to just simply sit down, write the date, and what do you want to know about the occult? And start a list of questions, whether it's definitions or concepts or applications or whatever it is. Write down a list of questions of things that you want to know about. And then, going by book titles and topic indexes, or indices, excuse me, that you can look at. Like, for example, you can look on Amazon.com and search by subject or keyword or something like that and come up with a lot of cool stuff. Amazon.com is where I find a lot of excellent information, and one of the cool features that they have is the look inside feature. If you know, a lot of the books are highlighted and they've scanned in the table of contents in the first several pages in the index, which brings me to a point that I hope my viewers don't in any way feel like I'm talking down to them or in any way belittling their intelligence by featuring the parts of a book in this video. When you're picking up a new occult book, it's important to look at the table of contents. Well, first of all, the back of the book, which whatever information that'll give you about the topic. Read the table of contents. I'm turned off personally by books that just have numbers for chapter headings. It doesn't help you know what you're looking at. Older books will have abstracts, which is a little list of the topics contained in each chapter. A lot of the Dover editions and stuff like that, the older, you find that in books older than the 1950s. You'll occasionally find a new one, but not very many. The Idiot's Guide series has abstracts in the table of contents. That's a way to look that up and see what that's like. But it tells you, it's a quicker way to find what you're looking for. Also, get used to looking at the index. So a book that doesn't have an index, you know, that's points off right there. I mean, you know, there are no five-star reviews for books without indices or good table of contents. I mean, you can't find your way through the book. If there's an overview or an introduction of any sort, obviously check that out. These are the feel that you can get just at a glance of looking at a book. And note the reading level that the book is written on. If most people have got a pretty good idea what sort of books are over their head, whether the English is too difficult or whatever language you're reading in, whether the language is too difficult or if it's too much of an academic book or it's just not very well written, it's too dry, whatever. Just be aware of how a book is written. Yeah, the tone of it, the attitude of it, and as well as, like I said, the sentence structure and the vocabulary level. You don't want to read a book that's talking down to you unless it's the only one you have. And in the beginning, I started with some of the worst books that have ever been written on anything. So where you begin is not where you end, and the second book you read about the occult is far more important than the first. It just helps you get started. So once you've got your notebook and you've picked up a book that seems interesting to you according to your list of questions or words you want to find or whatever, take notes on things that you learned. What I do is I have a separate notebook wherein I just write things from wherever I get it. If I get it off of the internet, if I find it from a conversation with somebody, or somebody shows me something, or whatever, anything new gets written down in this notebook. Questions based on that are written down, and I can follow up on them. I write down the names of authors and books that I want to get, or that seem interesting. I have a never-ending list of books that I want, which I will probably never obtain, and certainly never read. But, you know, it's good to keep the list anyway. But new information, things that seem, you know, that pique your curiosity and make you want to study the occult more, keep notes on it. And write down questions you have regarding each new thing that you come across. Now, that's bits as they come to you, and when you start looking at a particular book,